Hi everyone, in this session we are going to see some of the tutorial problems in Fourier series method. So the first problem is how to design an ideal low pass filter with a given frequency response of HD of e power j omega is equal to 1 for minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 and is equal to 0 for pi by 2 to pi. Okay. So for this particular frequency response, we can draw the graphical representation like this. That is, with respect to omega and HD of omega, always the magnitude is going to be 1 irrespective of the type of filter here in Fourier series method. So what are the limits given? It is taking the magnitude of 1 from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay. So find the values of h of n for capital N is equal to 11. And find h of z. Finally, plot the magnitude response. We have seen there are 5 steps in designing a Fourier series, FIR filter using Fourier series method, right? So the first step is the frequency response of the low pass filter with omega c is equal to pi by 2 is actually given by, so write out the function as such whatever is given. So this is hd of e power j omega, right? What is the second step? We are supposed to find out the impulse response. So HD of n is equal to, we know the formula, it is 1 by 2 pi into the summation of minus pi to pi HD of e power j omega into e power j omega n into d omega. We know that HD of e power j omega is equal to 1. So for the given limits alone, wherever it is having 1 magnitude, you take the limit, you take the that limits alone. Okay. So it is 1 for minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So I am making it finite. Okay. So into e power j omega n into d omega, then integrate it. We substitute the limits, we get the function sine pi by 2 into n divided by pi n, which is there for infinite limits, that is minus infinity to infinity. Now, what is the value of capital N given? Capital N is given as 11 samples. So, we have to truncate HD of N from infinite to finite. Finite is to 11 samples, right? Now, we have H of N is equal to, so we can write H of N is equal to HD of N as per symmetry, right? So, H of N is equal to sine pi by 2 N by pi N for the value of N lesser than or equal to, actually the formula is N minus 1 by 2, right? Our N value is 11, so 11 minus 1 by 2 becomes 10 minus 10 by 2 becomes 5, right? So, and it takes the value 0 for otherwise. For the value of N equal to 0, if you substitute in this equation, it becomes indeterminate. It is becoming 0 by 0 format. So, now what do we apply here? You go in for sinc function. What is sinc function? Limit N tends to 0, sine pi by 2 into N divided by pi N is equal to, what do you know? So just take out the constants and write down the value. We know that limit theta tends to 0, sine theta by theta is equal to 1. So that is what we are writing here. So do it. It gets simplified. Now, after substituting the value N equal to 0, we get the value 1 by 2. So, after using this sine theta by theta format, we are not getting indeterminate format. Sorry, yeah, right. The next one is for N equal to 1. So, substitute N equal to 1. The formula is once again the same thing. H of N is equal to HD of N is equal to sine pi by 2 N divided by pi N. Go back and substitute in that. Now, since we are saying that it is having linear phase in the sense, phase response of the filter is proportional to the linear frequency, that is linear frequency of the filter, right? So, in that case, H of 1 is equal to H of minus 1, right? So, if you are obtaining the value for H of 1, it is more than enough. Now, substitute the value of N is equal to 1 here and get the answer. Similarly, substitute it for 2, 3, 4 and 5, which means it is symmetric, right? right? Now, how can we write the transfer function of the filter? This is all simple formula substitution. We all know the steps, right? So, h of z is equal to h of 0 plus summation of n equal to 1 to n minus 1 by 2, h of n into z power n plus z power minus n. So, substitute in this formula, expand this and substitute the values of h of n whichever we have obtained, we will get the final transfer function h of z, right? So, the transfer function is now a non-causal, non-realizable one. So, how will you make it a realizable filter? I told you the last step is to multiply it with z to the power of minus of n minus 1 by 2. So, multiplying it, right? So this is the equation after multiplying, right? So, from this, since I told you linear phase, so the filter coefficients of the causal filter are given by, now you have to write according to the symmetry. So, h of 0 is now equal to h of 10, and then h of 1 is equal to h of 9, h of 2 is equal to h of 8. So, substitute all these things. Finally, the frequency response of the filter is given by h bar of e power j omega is equal to the summation of n equal to 0 to 5 a of n into cos omega n, where a of 0 is equal to h of n minus 1 by 2, whereas a of n is equal to 2h of n minus 1 divided by 2 minus n. So, this is for the case when n is odd and symmetric, right? So, after substituting the values of n here, we get the frequency response function h bar of e power j omega. So, this is supposed to be the frequency response function. Now, what have they asked? They have asked us to find out what is the frequency response. The magnitude in dB is calculated by varying omega from 0 to pi and tabulated below. The magnitude modulus of e power j omega in dB can be written as 20 log of h bar of e power j omega. So, substituting the value of omega in degrees from 0 to 180 degrees, we obtain this graph. Okay, so the graph is plotted between omega and modulus of h of e power j omega, right? So, this is the case of a filter. Now, the next problem is a high pass filter. The procedure is same. Depending upon the limits, you do the same, you execute the same steps, right? Now, the filter given to us is a high pass filter. Simply on seeing the frequency response of the filter, draw the diagram. So, the pictorial representation will always give us a clear picture. Now, how will you write this HD of n? We are supposed to find out what is the impulse response. HD of n is actually, the general formula is this, but it takes the value 1 from minus pi to minus pi by 4 and pi by 4 to pi. So, split those limits. Once again, substitute it, we get this equation, right? So, now once again, HD of n has to be truncated to 11 samples. What is this truncation? See, this actually truncation, the abrupt truncation of the samples results in oscillations in passband and stopband. We call that phenomena as Gibbs phenomena. This is occurring mainly in Fourier series because of the discontinuities in the series. Okay, right. So, h of n is equal to hd of n for modulus of n is less than or equal to 5. The same thing. Once again, I told you for 0, when you substitute n is equal to 0, it becomes indeterminate format. So, apply the sinc function and find out the value of h of 0, right? So, similarly, obtain h of 1, h of 2, h of 3, h of 4, h of 5. Transfer function, make it a realizable filter by multiplying it by z to the power of minus of n minus 1 by 2 and find out what is the equation for a frequency. So, frequency response is now calculated by using this formula. I told you it is symmetric and n is odd. So, apply this, you get this frequency response, right? So, draw this frequency response after substituting. Here in this problem, 0 to 90 degrees they have substituted, it is up to us. Okay, we can substitute up to 0 to 180 or 0 to 90 degrees. The next problem is an ideal band pass filter. This is very, very important and in the examination point of view. So band pass filter, what do you mean by band pass? We already saw in unit 2. Band passes for a particular band, it will allow. For a range of frequencies, it will allow. And for the rest of the frequencies, it will suppress. Here the given value and the limits are here. According to that, you draw the graph and understand the graph. So the idea, see, now can be splitted according to the limits given to us. The same procedure as what we did for low pass filter and high pass filter, right? So 11 samples, h of n is equal to hd of n, then find out what is h of 0, right? All the values of h of n, find out what is the transfer function h of z, then obtain the realizable filter, then find frequency response. Right, so this is how we design FIR filters using Fourier series method. Thank you.